man's law and God's law, they have different sets of characteristics.
We have unimpeachable evidence in the Bible to show this kind of divine love.
Basically, it covers all the aspects of human life.
Maligayang panonood, Pilipinas, at sa ating mga minamahal na mga kapatid at kababayan sa Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao, welcome muli sa ating programa, The Chemistry of Law, Love, and Life. Ang iyo pong lingkod, Attorney June Sumagaysay, at kasama ko yon si Attorney Randall T.
Good day, Attorney June. I would like to say hi to all our friends watching outside the Philippines on TV and joining us online. This is the second episode of The Chemistry of Law, Love, and Life. We welcome you.
Attorney Randall, nagpapasalamat ulit tayo sa ating Panginoon dahil binigyan tayo ng time sa una nating episode at sa continuing na pagtulong ng ating Panginoon para sa ating episode 2, okay, which is the Ten Commandments.
And we are learning.
Yes.
Moving forward, we are learning every day, Attorney June, right?
That's right, because of God's providence.
Yes, and do you want to greet someone?
Yes.
I understand.
I also want to take this opportunity to greet my family there in Pasig, including my friends in Maybunga, Pasig City.
Yes, and I'm inspired today because my wife and my three-year-old daughter, both of them are watching.
And of course, all the televiewers of this program.
We are glad you joined us today.
Thank you so much again, my dear brothers and sisters. So, Attorney Randall, the topic we are going to discuss now is about the Ten Commandments.
Yes.
Okay. Now, Attorney Randall, sa movie na The Ten Commandments, we can easily notice na ang first tablet of stone ay mayroon lamang apat. Yes. And the second tablet ay mayroong anim. Mm-hmm. Bakit hindi lima, lima?
Okay. That's a good question, Attorney June, no? Before we talked about that, I would like to remind our viewers the characteristics of the Ten Commandments.
Okay, by way of recapitulation.
By way of recapitulation, yeah.
Okay.
The Ten Commandments is eternal, again, unchanging.
Okay.
Okay, it's infallible.
Okay.
And it's perfect and it's unbiased. Now, moving towards the question, bakit po hindi lima-lima yung tablet? Now, the first four commandments as written on the tablets of stones, ito po, these commandments deal with our relationship with our Lord.
Okay.
Okay, with our God.
That's why ang sinasabi po dito, thou shalt have no other gods before me.
Okay. Yes.
And the second tablet.
The second tablet, the commandments written on that deal as regards to our relationship with our fellow human being.
Okay.
To our families, to our parents, to our friends and neighbors.
Okay.
So this is a, they call it the first tablet. The first tablet is a vertical relationship.
Okay.
And the second tablet pertains to our horizontal relationship.
Okay.
All right.
So, i-affirm lang natin na Attorney Randall ang Ten Commandments na ito dahil meron ibang mga opinion na ito daw ang Ten Commandments na ito ay Ten Commandments ito ni Moses. Okay? Gusto lang natin i-bigyan ng diin na Attorney Randall na ang Ten Commandments na ito ay hindi ito ay Ten Commandments ni Moses.
Right.
Si Moses lamang ay nagiging chosen vessel siya ng ating Panginoon. Okay? Now, when in fact, Attorney Randall, dito sa Ten Commandments na ito, sa Exodus chapter 20, verse 1, malinaw na malinaw ang sinasabi dito ng the Bible. And God spoke these things to Moses. Ibig sabihin, ito ay ang salita ng Diyos, ito ay ang batas ng Diyos. Bagamat ito ang Ten Commandments, ay nakapaloob ito sa libro ni Moses called Pentateuch, ito ay clearly the word of God.
So ito ay hindi limited dun sa panahon ni Moses lamang.
Yes.
Ito po ay applicable as we speak today.
Yes. Kung matandaan mo, Attorney Randall, during our first episode, I cited one biblical verse, Psalm 119, verse 160.
Yes, yes, I remember.
Your words are true, and your righteous laws are eternal. Meaning to say, this is not only applicable during the time of the Old Testament, but also today.
Attorney June, looking at the first commandment,
okay.
It says, thou shalt have no other gods before me.
Okay.
Ano po yung meaning nito?
Okay. It's not G,
capital?
Na capital letter. Okay. Dahil dito, Attorney Randall, from Genesis to Revelations, yung G na capital letter, this represents, or ito ay points, okay, sa all-powerful God na ating pinaniwalaan ngayon. Okay?
Okay.
Now, dito sa first commandment, thou shalt have no other gods before me, ay marami kasing mga Diyos-Diyosan ang mga Egyptians at the time. Okay? Titingnan natin ng history briefly. Okay? Now, pumunta ang bansang Israel sa Egypt. Okay? Una muna ang families ni Jacob, 70 of them pumunta doon. And they were in the territory of Egypt for 430 years.
Nagiging slave
sila.
Right.
Okay? And there are Bible scholars na nagsasabi, and even the Bible is replete with evidence, na ang ibang mga tauhan ng Diyos, okay, contracted intermarriage with the Egyptians. Okay? Now, dito makikita natin na ang mga Egyptians, marami silang mga Diyos-Diyosan. Okay? Halimbawa, Brother Randall, kung pumunta sila, mag-hunting sila, ang tinatawagan nila na Diyos ay si Anhur. Okay? Now, meron rin silang Diyos-Diyosan na tinatawag nila dito, ang pangalan ay si Aker. Siya ang God of the Earth. Okay?
Okay.
There were more than 100 na mga Diyos-Diyosan na ito, ang mga Egyptians natin.
So meaning, Attorney June, iba't ibang celebration, iba't ibang occasion, may
ibang
Diyos.
Yes.
Oh.
Kung minsan, Brother Randall, sa atin dito sa Pilipinas, di ba? Kung ang isang may asawang babae, hindi nabuntis, di ba?
Tama.
Instead of praying to God,
yes.
Okay, the creator of the universe, pupunta sila doon sa north.
At mag...
At sabi na nila, sasayaw ka.
Oh, okay. Ito ba yung tama?
Sasayaw ka.
Narinig ko yan. Oo.
I-relate rin natin ito, Brother Randall. Kung sila ay may gagawin sila particular trade, okay, pupunta sila sa kanilang Diyos-Diyosan. Okay?
Hindi kayo nakakalito yan, Antonio.
Kaya nga, itong Brother Randall, ang emphasis dito, thou shalt have no other gods before me. Dahil sinasabi dito na I am a jealous God. Okay? I am a jealous God. Binigyan lamang emphasis dito na wala nang ibang all-powerful God except, okay, ang Diyos ni Abraham, ang Diyos ni Jacob, at ang Diyos ni Enoch.
So,
ito ngayon ang ating pinaniniwalaan.
So we have to worship the one true God.
The one true God.
Okay.
Dahil siya lamang ang all-powerful because siya ang creator ng lahat ng mga bagay dito sa mundo.
Ito, Attorney June, you've touched on the historical background of the commandment, no? Is this applicable today?
Yes.
Yung sinasabi natin na yung other gods, the small letter G, do we have any modern-day gods?
Ang emphasis dito, Attorney Randall, okay? Ang ating loyalty sa ating Panginoon. Okay? Now, siya lamang ang ating dapat isambahin. Okay? Now, sa tanong mo, napakaganda yun, Brother Randall. Dahil kung minsan, Brother Randall, ang ating focus, kung minsan wala na sa Panginoon,
tama.
Puro na lang trabaho ating ginagawa. We exerted all our efforts, okay, for the entire 24 hours, and then kulang lang ating panahon magbasa ng Bible. Kulang lang ating panahon para magkaroon tayo ng reflection sa kagandahan ng ating Panginoon. We may consider that also as mga Diyos-Diyosan.
Yung trabaho.
As an idolatry. Okay?
Yung trabaho
now,
natin.
The work itself, hindi po yan idol natin.
Tama.
Okay? But if we are going to spend most of our time, okay, attending to these secular activities.
Correct.
Okay, depriving ourselves, okay, sa mga bagay na spiritual, okay, we may consider that as idolatry. Okay?
Pag hindi na natin binibigyan ng priority ang Panginoon, if we give more priority to our secular endeavors, tapos we disregard our relationship with God,
okay,
ito po ay makonsider na violation.
Yes, makonsider rin ito, Brother Randall, particularly ito sa may pangalawang commandments ng ating Panginoon.
Which is ito ang...
About true worship.
True worship.
Okay. So dito, Brother Randall, binigyan talaga dito ng emphasis, okay, na siya lamang ang Diyos ng buhay. Siya lang ang Diyos who created all of us. Siya lang ang Diyos who sustained life.
Right. So it says, thou shalt not make unto thee any graven
image. Okay.
In our modern day society.
Now, sa akin kanina ng explanations doon, sometimes ang ating trabaho, ginagawa na natin idol. Okay?
Right.
Sometimes, ang ibang mga bagay, other than our works, doon, ibinuhos natin ang ating mga time. Mm-hmm. Okay? Pero maliit lamang ang binibigay natin sa ating Panginoon. So, okay? So, sa aking opinion, okay, all these things, okay, may take a form of idolatry. Dahil ang Panginoon, hindi na natin binibigyan, okay, ng sapat na time ang ating Panginoon.
So, it says, Attorney June, God wants us to worship Him directly, right?
Yes.
We do not need to bow down to any image.
Yes.
All we need to do is pray directly to Him, and that's
what is precisely, that is precisely the message here. Yes. Dahil kung matandaan mo, Attorney Randall, when Moses was already in Mount Sinai, where God spoke the Ten Commandments and etched the Ten Commandments by means of his fingers, okay, makikita natin doon may mga idols sila, okay? Right. So ito ang kanilang worship. At dito, kahit na ito ang image ng ating Panginoon, but the Bible is very clear. All graven image. Babasahin ko for the benefit of the televiewers.
Yes, please, okay. Please, Attorney June.
The second commandment, which is found in Exodus chapter 20, verse 4, says, thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above.
Right.
Kasama dito ang ating Panginoon, okay? Or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Okay, anong pang sabi ng ating Panginoon? Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them,
yes,
nor serve them. For I, the Lord, thy God, am a jealous God. Ibig sabihin, kahit meron pang almost perfect replica ni Jesus Christ, almost perfect replica ng mga angel, the second commandment forbids us to worship them.
So claro,
to
claro,
bow down to them.
Claro, Attorney June,
yes,
no? Hindi tayo mag-detour, kundi pwede naman tayong dumiretso sa Panginoon. Okay.
Attorney Randall, lest we forget, okay, dito sa my first commandment na ito, okay, God will like to demand from us loyalty. Okay? Now, along a similar vein, okay, we have this earthly government.
Correct.
Okay? Of course, ang ating gobyerno gusto rin magiging loyal sa atin.
Tama.
What would the government think? What would the government feel kung ang kanyang citizen hindi loyal sa kanya?
Kung yung kanyang subjects,
oh,
no?
Yes.
Tayo. Pero ito, Attorney June, may tinatawag sa ating batas ngayon, may dual citizenship.
Okay.
Dual citizenship. Mm. Pero hindi nangangahulugan na ang isang Pilipino, porket siya ay nagiging U.S. citizen or any other of any other citizenship,
yes, okay,
eh, hindi na siya magiging Filipino.
Yes, and it is very clear doon sa Dual Citizenship Act na once siya ang nagiging U.S. citizen at the same time, hindi niya ina-abdicate ang kanyang allegiance sa Philippine government.
Right, okay? Right.
Andun pa rin ang element of loyalty.
So dito papasok yung loyalty, yung
yes,
allegiance.
Yes.
Yung allegiance. So even if you are a citizen of two countries,
yes,
sa dual citizenship law natin, yung allegiance mo,
yes,
dapat nasa Pilipinas pa rin.
Yes, yes.
All right. So that is clear, Attorney yes. June, that is clear. So we go to the third commandment.
Okay.
Okay, the third commandment says, thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain.
Yes.
Yung pangalan ng Panginoon, mga kapatid, ito po ay sagrado.
Yes.
We should not find in ourselves to take the name of yeah. God in vain.
Yes.
Paminsan-minsan, pag tayo ay nabibigla, yeah. ang nabibigkas natin, yung masama, ano?
Yes, sir. So, simple lang ito, Attorney Randel. Okay, pangalan mo ay Randel.
Mm.
Okay? Kung tatawagin kita ng ibang pangalan na hindi maganda, okay, ano kaya ang magiging reaction mo?
Ako.
Okay?
Ano yan?
That's why.
Parang minomorder mo yung pangalan ko.
Yes, oh. That is why God requires us, okay, reverence and awe. Okay? Haharap tayo sa Kanya. Kung hindi man tayo harap sa Kanya sa church, okay, sa ating mga personal na ginagawa, okay, we shall maintain the reverence.
Tama.
Okay?
Tama. At tatawagin natin yung totoong pangalan ng Panginoon.
Yes.
No? Okay. Hindi natin gamitin sa masama.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Attorney June, the Ten Commandments, okay, I have heard this a lot of times, that the Ten Commandments ay para lang yan sa kay Moses. At okay. na-explain mo yan kanina na dapat applicable pa rin ngayon kasi
yes,
unchanging.
Yes, yes.
Okay. Pero may nagsasabi pa rin, eto. Totoo, the commandments of God, we follow it today.
Okay.
All right, we follow it. Except the fourth commandment.
Okay.
Kasi iyan, hindi na applicable ngayon kasi
okay.
nasa bagong tipan na tayo. We are under the new law. Ano po yung masasabi mo?
Ang iba pa niyan, Attorney Randel, sabi nila na abolish na ito ang sabat na ito under the New Testament.
Mm-hmm.
Pero kung papasahin natin, Attorney Randel, the entire Bible, mm-hmm. okay, makikita natin na kasama rin ito sa ating Ten Commandments. Okay? Now, una dito, Randel, nagbigay na tayo ng pahayag nung sa first episode, Isaiah chapter 40, verse 8, mm-hmm. okay, that the law of God shall firm, okay, shall stand forever, mm-hmm. okay. At meron pa rin isa ka-text na gusto ko babasahin, Randel, if you want to read it,
yes,
sa
yes,
Matthew
please.
Chapter 5, verses 17. Pwede mo mabasa?
Yes, I will read from the clear word, Matthew 5:17 to 18?
And 18. Okay.
And 18, yes. Don't think that I'm doing away with the law or the prophets.
Okay.
I am the embodiment of the law. I have not come to change it, but to carry it out. Verse 18. Not the smallest letter, nor the least stroke of a pen will ever change any more than heaven and earth can disappear before everything is accomplished.
So again, the Bible is so clear to be misinterpreted. Aking babasahin, Randel, sa my New King James Versions para at least maintindihan natin.
Yes,
okay?
Yes, please.
Ito ang sinasabi sa my New King James Version. Think not that I am come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy but to fulfill. Mm-hmm. Okay? Ang emphasis
claro
again
yan, no?
dito
to
sa
fulfill.
Verse 18.
Mm-hmm.
For verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass, one jot, okay, or one tittle shall in no wise pass from the law till all be fulfilled. Now, ito, i-emphasize dito sa Matthew chapter 5, verse 18. Na, even one letter, for instance, thou, okay,
and
kahit
nang
T, okay, hindi yan mawawala sa Ten Commandments, okay? That's eternal forever, okay? Ano ang sinasabi rin dito na tittle, okay? For instance, ito yung T.
Mm-hmm.
Ang tapyas ng isang
yes.
line na ito, okay, title, okay, yun sila ay hindi mawawala. So the fourth commandment, which I shall read, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy, has not been abolished. It is still part and parcel of the Ten Commandments.
Thank you for that clarification, Attorney June. But I would like to ask you, and perhaps our televiewers have the same question, okay? When you look at the Ten Commandments from 1 to 10, only the fourth starts with the word remember. The rest, thou shalt not have no other gods, thou shalt not make, thou shalt, In fact, the fifth commandment says honor their father, but okay. That's also a command. I'm just curious, why the word remember, Attorney John?
Okay, magandang tanong yung Attorney Randel. Mm-hmm. Yun rin ang sinasabi ng iba na ito ay hindi batas dahil nakalagay lamang dito, remember lang. Mm-hmm. Okay. Before ko ito, Attorney Randel, explain, maraming mga text sa Bible na nagsasabi remember. Mm-hmm. Okay, una, doon sa may Luke, ang si Jesus Christ nagsabi, remember Lot's wife. Okay? Mm-hmm. Dito naman sa Ecclesiastes, nakalagay naman doon, remember the days of the youth. Okay? Mm-hmm. At dito naman sa Ten Commandments, sa Fourth Commandment, remember the Sabbath day. Ang salitang word naman, remember. Okay? Uh-huh. God merely wants to underscores the importance of these words because tayo as a human being, okay, we have the tendency to forget. Uh-huh. That is why He says, remember the Sabbath
day. Very specific, huh?
Yes,
very specific.
Because if we do not remember the 7 days Sabbath, okay, which is Saturday, mm-hmm. there will be dire consequences.
Picking up from your answer, Attorney June, yes. the Sabbath is the seventh day. Some are saying that the Sabbath should not fall on the seventh day.
Why? Because ang iba ay nangingili na araw ng Linggo, ang iba mm-hmm. Friday. Mm-hmm. Pero dapat yan, Attorney Randel, titingnan natin kung ano ang first day of reckoning natin. Okay? Mm-hmm. Sunday ba as the first day? Mm-hmm. Or is it Monday as the first day of the week? Mm-hmm. Kung ang first day of the week is Monday, totoo, the seventh day is Sunday. Mm-hmm. Pero, ang first day na tinutukoy dito, Attorney Randel, ay walang iba kundi ang the first day of the week, which is Sunday. Mm-hmm. Monday is the first working day of the week. Mm-hmm. Okay, reckoning from the first day, Sunday, therefore the seventh day is Saturday. Ang ginagamit natin ngayon na kalendaryo ay Gregorian calendar.
Right.
Where the first day of the week is Sunday.
Yes.
Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and the seventh day. Mm-hmm. Oh, very clear ang Ten Commandments. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days.
The first 6 days.
Shalt thou work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord our God. Anong sinasabi ng ating Panginoon? Okay, He rested on the seventh day after the creation. He blessed it and He made it holy. That is a command.
So okay? there's no quarrel, Attorney June. The Sabbath is the seventh day.
Yes. Titingnan natin biblical verse.
Yes.
Para malaman ng ating televiewers na ang first day of the week is Sunday and that Monday.
Mark chapter 16 verse 1. I'm reading from the Clear Word again. Okay. The next night after the sun had set,
okay,
and the Sabbath had ended,
okay,
Mary Magdalene, Mary, the mother of the younger James and Joseph, and Salome, the wife of Zebedee, bought additional burial spices so they could go to the tomb to anoint the body first thing in the morning.
Okay, first thing in the morning.
First thing in the morning.
Okay.
I would like you to read from the King James
yes.
Version.
Mas clearer, Attorney Randel, dito yung sa may mark para makita natin dahil mm-hmm. ang sinasabi do, first thing in the morning. Okay? Pero dito, Attorney Randel, sa may New King James Version, sa Mark chapter 16. And when the Sabbath was past, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James and Salome, had bought sweet spices that they might come and anoint him. Verse 2, and very early in the morning, the first day of the week.
And that's very clear. Okay. First day of the week.
The first day of the week, they came unto the sepulchre at the rising of the sun. Okay. The entire world ay alam mm-hmm. ng ating Panginoon was resurrected on what day? It was?
Sunday.
Sunday.
Yes.
Okay. So, ang sinasabi sa ito, the first day of the week, mm-hmm. meaning to say, the first day of the week is Sunday, mm-hmm. counting therefrom, the seventh day is therefore Saturday.
So that's very clear, and I hope our viewers watching right now would take the cue, I mean, take it directly from the Bible, right? That the seventh day Sabbath is still in force. It is still applicable even as we speak today, yeah. And it has never changed, Attorney
Yes,
John.
That's
it has
right.
never changed.
Okay. So, Attorney Randel, Our time is about to run out. And atin na rin na-discuss during sa first episode ang characteristics ng law and the part of the Ten Commandments dito sa may second episode. Can you please tell the televiewers, Attorney Randel, the summary of what we discussed?
We talked about the first four commandments. These four commandments deal with our relationship with our Lord Jesus Christ. It is very important to underscore that these first four and the rest of the Ten Commandments are still in force up to today. It has never changed, and it will never change.
Yes.
And Attorney Jun, I would like to emphasize this also, that our Lord has risen, and we are serving a risen Lord.
Yes.
The Sabbath is a sign between our relationship with Him. And the fourth commandment is very important. Yes. And as we wrap up this episode, I would like to remind our viewers that we will be talking in the next episode of the next six commandments.
Okay.
And we will deal with it during the next episode, okay. Attorney John.
Sa ating mga kababayan at ating mga kapatid, na-tackle na po namin ang first four commandments at kami po ni Attorney Randel ay napapasalamat sa inyo sa inyong patuloy na pagsubaybay at panunood sa ating programa, The Chemistry of Law, Love and Life. And Attorney Randel, we are going to wrap this up with thanksgiving sa ating Panginoon. Okay, shall we pray? Our Heavenly Father, we thank you so much because we know that you are the God of love. You are our living God, our living hope. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for your faithfulness and for your love as manifested by the Ten Commandments. We pray, Heavenly Father, for the outpouring of the Holy Spirit so that we will be able to learn more about God. We will be able to learn more about Jesus. And we are also praying for our televiewers, for their families here in the Philippines and outside of the Philippine soil, that you also bless them. We are also praying, Heavenly Father, for our country, the Philippines. May your blessings be upon our leaders. Enable them to perform their duties in accordance with your will. This we ask together with the forgiveness of our sins. Amen.
Amen.
Kami po ay nagpapasalamat muli sa inyong pagsubaybay sa aming programang ito. And once again, we are inviting you to watch our next episode. Ang iyong pong lingkod, Attorney Jun Sumagaysay.
At ako naman po, si Attorney Randel T.
At ito po ang The Chemistry of Law, Love and Life.